Hello everyone, in this video we will learn about pteridophytes. So the pteridophytes includes horsetail and ferns, and these pteridophytes are basically used for the medical purpose and for the soil binders. Medical purpose means we are making so many of medicines from them, and also they are used for binding the soil so that they can prevent the soil erosion. Now they are also frequently grown as ornamental, that means for showing the other, that means for the decorative purpose we are using them. And evolutionary, they are the first terrestrial plant, that means these are the first plant that are able to live properly on the land. So they are the first terrestrial plant, and they are also having a vascular tissues, xylem and phloem. Now these pteridophytes are found in cool, damp, shady place through some of flourish well in the sandy soil condition. So most of them are found in the cool and damp place, but some of them can easily found in the sandy soil also. Now as we learned previously that the bryophyte have a dominant phase in life cycle is the gametophytic plant body. That means in them the gametophyte plant body is the dominant factor or the dominant phase. But when we talk about the pteridophytes, in them the dominant plant body is the sporophyte. So sporophyte is dominant in the pteridophyte, while in bryophyte the gametophyte was the dominant. And this sporophyte which is found in the pteridophyte, it is having a well differentiated vascular tissue, and they are also having a true leaf, stem and roots. We learned previously that a bryophyte do not have the true leaf, stem and roots, but in pteridophytes they have the true root, stem and leaves. Now in pteridophytes they are having two type of leaf. First is small and second is the large one. So the small one we call them microphylls, and the large one we call them macrophylls. So microphylls are found in Selaginella, and large, that we call the macrophylls, it is found in ferns. Now the sporophyte bears sporangia that are substanted by leaf-like appendages called the sporophylls. So whenever we are talking about the sporangia which is found in the sporophyte, it is covered or it is organized by a leaf-like structure or appendages that we call the sporophylls. In some cases, the sporophylls may form the distinct compact structure called the strobili or cone. That means in some cases what is happening, these sporophylls are basically combined to form a distinct structure that we call the strobili or the cone, which is found in basically Selaginella and Equisetum. Now these sporangia will produce the spores by meiosis in spore mother cells. So whenever the spore mother cells undergo meiosis, it will produce the spores, and whenever these spores will germinate, it will produce a inconspicuous small but multicellular gametophyte. So just because these spores are haploid, so it will produce the gametophyte. And this gametophyte is free living, and mostly it is able to do photosynthesis. And this type of gametophyte is known as the prothallus. So whatever the gametophyte which is formed in the pteridophyte, we call them prothallus, which is free living, mostly photosynthetic. Now this gametophyte always required a cool and damp shady place to grow. Now just because these gametophytes required a cool, damp, shady place for grow, so because of this specific restriction requirement and the need of water for the fertilization, the spread of living pteridophyte is limited and restricted to a narrow geographical region. That means just because they need a cool, shady and damp place, and also they are needing or also they need the water for the fertilization, so due to that reason they are very much restricted to a particular geographical area. Now the gametophyte bears male and female sex organ called the ancidia and archegonia. So the male and female organ which is found in gametophyte, we call them ancidia and archegonia respectively. Now water is always needed to transfer a penthozoid, the male gamete released from the ancidia to the mouth of the archegonia. So whenever the male gamete will release, it will directly transfer to the mouth of the archegonium. Now, whenever the fusion of male and female gamete occur in the archegonium, it will result in the formation of zygote, and that zygote therefore produce is a multicellular, well-differentiated sporophyte, which is dominant phase of the pteridophyte. So whenever the fusion will occur, it will produce a zygote, and this zygote is a multicellular, it will form the multicellular sporophyte. And this sporophyte is the dominant phase of the pteridophyte. Now in majority of the pteridophyte, all spores are of same kind. That means whatever the spores are produced, they are not different, they are always of same type, and these type of spores are known as the homosporous. Now some genera are like Selaginella and Selvinia, which provide or which produce two type of spores. First is the macrospore and second is the microspore, and this type of spore production is known as the heterosporous. So in most of the pteridophyte, they are producing only same type of spores, we call them homosporous, but in some of the sporophyte, or sorry, some of the pteridophyte, they are producing two different type of spores that we call the heterosporous. So the megaspore and the microspore, whenever they are germinating, it will produce the female and male gametophyte respectively. That means from the megaspore, female gametophyte will form, and from microspore, male gametophyte will form. Now the female gametophyte in these plants are retained on the plant sporophyte for valuable period. That means it will not germinate on other portion, it is remained or it is retained on the sporophyte. And the development of the zygote into young embryo is take place within the female gametophyte. So whatever the fertilization occurs, it will occur in the female gametophyte, and this female gametophyte is still on the sporophyte. Now this event is a precursor to the seed habit, considered an important step in evolution. Means if we talk about the seed habit, then that what is happening, whatever the embryo is formed, it is inside the female gametophyte. So here also the seed habit or the zygote is formed inside the gametophyte, and this gametophyte is present on the sporophyte. So it is similar to the seed habit, and it is very important in the evolution point of view. Now pteridophytes are further classified into four classes. First is Psilopsida, example is Psilotum. Second is the Lycopsida, example is Selaginella and Lycopodium. Third is the Sphenopsida, example is Equisetum. And fourth is the Pteropsida, example is Dryopteris, Pteris and Adiantum. So these are the classified pteridophytes. Now this is a diagram of a Selaginella and Equisetum. So in this we can easily see the clear root, stem and leaves. So the root, stem and leaf is clearly found in the Selaginella, and they also have a truly branch. They also have a rhizome to attach with the substratum. They have an internode, node, and the last portion, that is the strobilus.